I found out that a lot of the girls who were going into those sports, when I went to them, were not wearing their hijab and were not inviting their parents. And I was like, oh my God. The whole idea of this gym was to really empower them and be proud of who they are. And that's where we're like, okay, how can we really be behind you guys and support you guys? What is one thing that's stopping you? And a lot of them came back to, I just don't feel comfortable wearing my hijab when I'm playing. I don't feel like I'm part of the team. And I'm like, okay, if that's one thing, then let's find something where we can all work together and solve the issue.
The way that Fatima and I met is she sent an email to the Carlson School of Management where I was getting my MBA, looking for a business school student to help her take this project idea to a business. And the ask was, is there a student who can help us draft a business plan? I read up about what she was doing and I immediately responded, yes! Exclamation point.
Both Fatima with her passion in the community and Jamie with her passion for social enterprise and her background and strength as a very well-organized, thoughtful, strategic person, I was just really impressed with the team. So apart from what they actually had on paper for the business plan, I just looked at these two people. I said, well, they're just going to do something great.
What we were shocked about is that we had a large support from our non-Muslim community members who say, yeah, I can relate it. I have a young girl who plays sports. I can't imagine my niece or sister or neighbor not being able to have the same access.
She was getting a lot of support to take this work around modest activewear from a local project to a business that could help girls and women around the country and around the world. We knew the idea was strong, we knew there was an impact we could make. It was about the nuts and bolts of putting it together and creating a business that really required guidance and support from other people. Learning how to build a business and then also how to design and create apparel were two very new ventures for us, and so we needed guidance on both.
When you're starting out, it's just so great to talk to somebody who's just been there. You know, there's a lot of stress that's involved in starting a business, and you're pretty much on your own, you know. It might be a small organization, but you're at the peak of the organization, so they always say it's lonely at the top. Well, it's lonely starting a business, too. No business develops by itself. Nobody can take credit for doing everything themselves. It's true about the village, you know, it takes a village to raise a child. Well, it really takes a village to raise a business.
With Fatima and her connection with the community, we knew that there was a need. We had an idea that was resonating. We had prototypes that were on the right track. And then we knew kind of big picture that there was really something here from a broader perspective and that we could really drive a change.
In reality, all of us are part of the entrepreneurial community. We can open doors and connect people to new opportunities, and we can be first customers. If you're willing to take that kind of mini risk and download a new app that doesn't have that many users on it and try it out and give feedback, there is nothing greater that a founder can get than that early feedback from their potential market. But it takes someone taking a few of those extra steps or saying to their friends, hey, have you guys heard about this great new company? Or in Asiya's case, going to your kid's school and saying, I noticed that there are Muslim girls at this school, but they're not participating in sports or they're not on my kids' teams. How can we help them have that happen more effectively?
When I get everything from the different state agencies on, we have grant opportunities, I do lots of times tweet at certain nonprofits, hey, just to let you know, because I think it is exciting, and I think we as a legislature fund those because it creates jobs and it creates local jobs and it helps bring everybody up. So we're looking at how do we spend the money and what is our value and what do we value, and I think having a good, strong economy helps everybody, and that is literally helping people get jobs and keep jobs and start companies.
I think our entrepreneurial ecosystem has matured pretty rapidly over the past 5 years. We have some of the greatest pioneers in entrepreneurship in our history. The supercomputer is from Minnesota. Feeding the country at a scale is from Minnesota. The pacemaker and a ton of other technologies actually originated here. But now we have this next generation of innovators, and until about 5 years ago, that was all pretty siloed. And then a number of different organizations came together and said, we think we can do better together.
What really drives me to work as an entrepreneur and to drive this business is the impact that I truly think that we're making. We are a social venture, and for us it's to help more girls get into sports, more girls to be physically active and to have all those great experiences that will set them up for success later in life.
My parents told me, you can do anything you want, nothing can stop you. And right now, being a coach and seeing girls really saying, yeah, I'm playing, I'm not gonna stop, I can do anything I want, and still have and be equipped with the right hijab that will not stop me playing, it's something that is really amazing.